This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there again, welcome to episode 20. Last time we did transformations on absolute value functions. This time we're going to do more transformations, this time with square root functions. It looks a little bit different than what you're used to. Let's have a look. Alright, once again I've given you a graph. This time the graph is of the square root of x function. Notice it looks like an arc that points to the right and has a starting point at 0, 0. Once again, we're trying to do a transformation on the graph. We're going to move the vertex from 0, 0 to negative 2 and 4. And notice it starts out pointing right, but in the transformed version, it points left. Again, let's start by writing down the operations we've done to it. The first operation was that we have inverted the graph. But rather than inverting it vertically, we've inverted it horizontally. We've changed the right to the left. All right. The second thing we did was move the x-coordinate from 0 to negative 2. So we've moved left 2. And then the third thing we did, we started at y equals 0. Now it's at 4, so we have moved it up 4. Those are our transformations. Once again, we'll start with y equals root x rather than absolute value of x. Let's begin with our first operation. To invert horizontally, what you have to do is put a negative sign inside of the root, so that our function will change to y equals root negative x. This is different from what we did last time. If we had put it on the outside, we would have inverted vertically. Now we do another operation. Move it to the left 2. Now if we want to move left or right, we put a number inside the root. Also remember that we said if you'd like to move left, you put a positive sign on whatever number you're adding inside of the root. And if you want to move right, you put a negative number on whatever you're putting inside of the root. However, this is going to work a little bit differently from last time because of the negative x we've put there. I want you to be careful, because if you have a negative x inside of the root, that's going to change your rules. You are going to reverse the rules for this particular step. So left is no longer plus and right's no longer minus. They switch places. Left is now negative and right is now positive. That being said, let's try to write the new function. Again, we're trying to move left by 2. And this time left is negative because the negative x changed the rules. So we now have y equals root negative x minus 2 for our function. Now let's continue on to the third step. We want to now move up by 4. And remember, if you want to move up or down, we're going to put a number outside of the root. Also remember that if we're trying to move up, the number is positive, and if we're trying to move down, the number is negative. So our function is going to change again. We now have y equals root negative x minus 2 inside, and then since we're trying to move upward by 4, we place positive 4 outside the root. And that is our final function. Y equals root negative x minus 2 plus 4. All right, thank you all for watching. We'll do some more transformations next episode.